Well, the industry of label printers and packaging printers is exceptionally demanding. What you see is that there's pressure on price, there's a high demand for quality, and they have to face all kinds of different complexities, like different printing techniques, digital printing, high demands on higher flexibility, more changeovers, and all these are exceptionally demanding for the customers. I'm Atze Bosma, I'm CEO of MPS Systems. The industry of labeling and packaging demands a high level of presses. That is already challenging. But apart from these high level presses, also all the processes around need to be focused on. What we see in practice is that these presses do not run to the optimum level which is possible. Production is lower, then the speeds are lower, some waste is in practice, and we see that the flexibility is lower than that could be. So we need to focus on getting this waste down, getting performance up. And we can do this by placing sensors in the machine, making analysis of the data, and feedback that information back to the organization of our customers. And this gives them the possibility to improve their cycle and to get the productivity higher, to get the losses lower, and to be far more flexible.
What we see here is a very complex press. This press is equipped with a lot of sensors and collection mechanisms to get data out of the press. And with this data, we can really dive into the machine and exactly see what's happening. A few examples are the register sensor, the ink level sensor, or a tension sensor inside the machine. I'm Willem Meijer, I'm a data scientist at MPS Systems. Because you get so much insight in the machine, you can also see what the operator is doing, in which order he is doing it, and where are the bottlenecks of the operator process and what can be improved. We can see the roll change time. We can see what the operator does first and does second. And by applying our best practices on this roll change and the process of doing the roll change, we can really improve it. And by sparing the time, we can increase the productivity of the machine. So with our team, we get to know the customer, what's the problem and what are the challenges, and really help the customer to improve his specific process. And to do this, we use the data that comes from the machine.
We're working with the customer specifically on the theme of a changeover. And this customer is used to changeover timing like 50 minutes on average. So it took him 50 minutes to change from one material and one design to another one, with color changes and sleeves and everything which is needed in order to prepare for the next job. This 50 minutes, we could decrease this to 30 minutes. And that was only a few months' work together with the whole team. And we are now working on the next step from 30 minutes to get back to 15 minutes. And we know that 4 minutes is the absolute minimum. This is just an example of a case in which we improved the customer situation enormously. Other cases are like improving speeds from 100 to 150 meters per minute to reduce waste, which is impacting finance enormously, up to the hundreds of thousands of euros per year. Now we're looking to timing, minutes, speeds, wastes. So the next level will be to look at quality levels, supply chain, and we will use machine learning in order to understand all these processes and to be much easier improvement techniques. So by using data and intelligence, we can really move the industry to the next level.